guys, it's Becca. Welcome to my channel. Thank you so much for watching and hanging out with me today. It is that time again, and we're going to be talking about empties. And today, since I have so many empties of various types, I'm going to be splitting up my personal purchases that I've emptied out into two different categories. So the first video that I'm doing right now is going to be the skincare and body care and hair care empties, and the other one is going to be makeup and like perfumes and stuff like that. Alright, if you are interested to see what was good enough to finish up and what I might repurchase, just keep on watching. So we're going to be getting into it. I'm going to be talking about in this video the skincare, hair care, body care, deodorant, soaps, things like that in this video, all the things that I finished up. I have been trying to really whittle down my collection. I just started a low buy whereby I finish 10 items, and that earns me the right to purchase something that I've already got a surplus of, just because I want to, not because I need it. So I've been using a lot of samples. So I did end up finishing two sample or travel sizes of shampoo, conditioner type things. I did the Garnier Fructis one. I really like that one. But then also there was this Head & Shoulders mini size. I did finish a Head & Shoulders full size as well. And then I have Pantene 2-in-1 full size. Out of all of these, I do think this one is my favorite. And I probably will repurchase it, but maybe not the 2-in-1. I like to have my shampoo and my conditioner separate. There's one more hair product that I did finish, and this is the Hask Dry Shampoo and the Manoy Coconut one. Takes me very, very long time to finish up a dry shampoo of any size, so I thought that was a pretty big achievement to have finished one of these up. I've been working on it for months and months, but finally done with it, so I can start moving on to some of the other ones that I have in backup, because at a big hair sale from Ulta a while back, I was like, ooh, let me try all the different hair thingies, and yeah, they're still there. Do have a couple of deodorants that I finished. I'm not really sure how finished this one is. I did get this one from the Dollar Tree just because I was curious about it, and this one is supposed to be like a spritz deodorant thing. I didn't use very much of it, and I feel like it, like the spritzer didn't work anymore, because you can still hear there's product in there, but the spritzer doesn't work anymore. The other ones that I do like, you have probably already heard me talk about on my channel. I have this little Native deodorant. It's a little bitty mini here, apple and honeysuckle. Really like this one, smells super nice. The other one that I have is a full-size Lumi. This is the new scent Coconut Crush. It has that weird after scent that all of the Lumi products have. It's not my favorite, but I don't hate it. I do like this, and I do like the dispenser of it, so I will just like twist it up and like bloop across the top and use whatever's in there, but it's all gone. I'm going to talk about some of the samples that I finished, and they're all these little sample packets. Four of them are the same thing. They're these little It Cosmetics Confidence in a Cream sample packs. I finished all of them as a part of a project pan that I was doing, where I'm supposed to be using up the products that I really love, and I'd been saving these little guys for forever, and there was not really any reason to do that. I was thinking, oh, I'll just travel with them, but yeah, I haven't traveled in a while now, and neither has anybody else. So I finished these up so that I can get them out of my collection, pare down my numbers a little bit. Other sample packet that I finished, I got from a Sephora order. It's just this little fresh sugar strawberry wash. If this was cheaper than it is, I would probably purchase a full size of this, but as it is, it's not that different from the Skin Food version of the same thing. They have like a strawberry sugar wash too, and I really like that one, so whenever that goes on sale, I'll probably go ahead and repurchase that. Last sample I got here is this little CeraVe. It is a little moisturizer with SPF. I got it as a sample that went with a CVS order. Sometimes whenever I order something that from the beauty section, they will give me a little sample set, and usually it comes with this and a couple of other things that are pretty much the same every time, so I do have a few of these in backup because they kept sending me the same. I do have a couple of little packs here for bath bombs. This is all I was able to save from them. It's just this little wrapper. This one was one of those that has a prize inside, so my kids were really excited about that one. This one here is from a Walmart gift set that I got in the holiday, a little berry sorbet. It came with 9 little bath bombs, and I'm definitely still working through them, even though I got them last December, maybe in January. This one here has no name. I don't know what it was. It was purple, but I finished it. I did finish 2 hand soaps. One of them, I don't know that I should count completely, but it was in my kids' bathroom. There was just a little bit left of it, and I finished it. It was just one of those that you pick up at Walmart when there's things on clearance because, oh, that's useful. So we did finish this one up. Of course, the other one is not a surprise to anybody. This is Bath & Body Works, their foaming hand soap, which is one of my favorite products from that whole store. I will probably be stocking up again with their Hello Yellow sale in December. And this is the Life is a Peach one. It smells really good, and I enjoyed
it.
Got two lotions here. One is a Bath and Body Works one from years ago, I think. I don't know. I really liked this one. I finally pulled this out and said I have to use it. It's been sitting there for way too long. I'm going to probably pull off all the labels. They're just little stickers and reuse it because this is a really pretty, like, glass bottle. Makes me kind of think antique colors with this nice bronzy orange color, so I'm excited about that. And then I do have a face moisturizer also, getting up there in age. This is from Sephora. They don't even make this anymore. They haven't made it for a little while, and I really liked it, but it's gone now. And I think this was the last one. I did have two of these originally. I think this is the second one, and I finished them both now. I do have two body scrubs left from Bath and Body Works that I had finished this month. I believe this one was almost done last month, like just a little smidge at the bottom, and then I finished it. And then I went through this one. I'm not really sure how I went through it so quickly. Maybe one of them was already partially done. But I really liked this one. I did get a bunch of these whenever I got them at the Hello Yellow sale, however many years ago that was. I'm not sure, and I don't really want to know because I'm sure it's going to be embarrassing. I think I have one left from this series, and then I'll be all out of them. I did have to go buy some more body scrubs because I was down to my last one, which is super exciting because I had a pile of these at the beginning of the year, and I have really worked through them, and I'm super excited about that. The last five items here that I have are kind of a hodgepodge. I'll just go through them in no particular order. I do have first this Beauty Pie. This is their Dr. Glycolic Acid Pore Purifying Glow Toner. I did pour this into a different bottle. I'm using the one from The Ordinary, which has a much better dispenser. Like, this is okay. It's better than some of the other ones that I've seen, but the one from The Ordinary is the best dispenser that I've seen. So basically any kind of toner I put into those bottles and I reuse that bottle. This empty here is kind of odd, I guess. It is a Bath & Body Works Hair & Body Shimmer Spray. I don't remember actually using this, but I was just going through all of my collection and my stuff, basically, and seeing like, oh, that's kind of neat, and then I shook it and tried to spray it, and it didn't do it. So I was like, okay, I guess it's empty, so I'll count it as an empty, but I'm not sure when I actually finished this, because I don't remember using this in the last several months. One more item from Bath & Body Works this month, and it's going to be a shower gel. This time it is the Sweet Magnolia and Clementine shower gel. I did finish that this month, and I've already popped another one from my collection into the shower to start using. I really love this, especially when I can get it in the Hello Yellow sale and get all those fun scents because they all smell so, so good. Nothing really extra to say about this. I love these, and I'm still using them up, and I'll probably buy a bunch at the Hello Yellow sale in December or early January or whenever it is, and just have myself stocked up for the whole year at that point. All right, almost done. Two more items here. This one here is a little facial spray mist that I got from the Dollar Tree. I actually like this one. I would just, whenever I had finished washing my face, I just spritz it on there because it's really moisturizing and it gives me a little minute there so that I can put my body lotion on without my face getting dried out, and I just would spritz this on. I do like it. I have the next one already in line. It's a different scent. I like this one better. So if I were to repurchase either of them, it would be this one, but yeah, not bad. And then the very last item, finally, is this little Shop Misset AOA Studio Argan Oil Brush Soap. This is my favorite brush soap. Not necessarily this scent. This one is, what, peach? But all of them, I like them. They're so inexpensive. They work just fine. They have a great tin that I can reuse for like crafts and stuff. So yeah, I really enjoy these, and I've already went ahead and restocked because this was my very last one that I had. So I went and made another AOA order and basically bought a few more of these and some empty magnetic palettes. And that's it. So those are all the items that I have this month for hair care, body care, soaps, lotions, that kind of stuff. There are 28 products that I finished from those categories this month. I am super excited to be working through my collection and trying to earn myself some more products that I can purchase with my no-buy. So I have earned a few things, and I'm super excited to update on what kinds of little goodies that I did purchase that I earned. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. Hope you are staying healthy and safe and in good spirits. I will see you all in the next one. Bye!